Hello and welcome back to Switch and Lever. Some time ago in the magical land of Hell's Kitchen in New York, I went to a flea market with some really cool people. That resulted in a video where I made a pen from an old thermometer casing, but I also bought one other item intended for something much more glorious. The midget levelometer. Now, I tried to do some research what this thing is actually for, and from what I can gather, it's for measuring the level of liquid in tanks. It has a plunger in the bottom, which doesn't move the hand on the gauge, unless you block the broken off port at the top, which tells me that it measures the pressure in a system somehow. Either way, that kind of usage has passed. Since I don't have any giant tanks of liquid needing measuring, we're turning it into a novel item to help keep track of YouTube subscribers instead. Before we get that far, however, we need to do some mechanical surgery and remove some unnecessary parts. The plunger will be removed entirely, and most other things as well. We are, however, keeping the face of the levelometer, as well as the hand. Therefore, it's important to make note of its center of pivot, so we can put it back in the same place after we remove the entire underlying mechanism. It is a pretty neat mechanism though, with a metal bellows actuating a small cogwheel around the shaft of the hand. For those of you who are impatient, what we're basically doing is taking a microcontroller with Wi-Fi capabilities, together with a servo motor, an LED strip, and some other random bits and bobs, stuffing it into the enclosure and Bob's your uncle. For everyone else, let's get on with the build. Thank you. So let's pause the build here and talk electronics for a bit. I'm putting in two microcontroller boards into the levelometer. The first is a Wemos D1 Mini Pro, which will handle Wi-Fi communication and access to the YouTube API to get the current subscriber count, as well as the LED and servo controls. The other one is an Arduino Nano, which we will employ for speech synthesis. Indeed, we're going to make this thing speak without using pre-recorded audio, using an excellent library called Talkie for the Arduino. It's based on work done by Texas Instrument in speech synthesis back in the 1980s, and was used in several platforms like the BBC Acorn, Apple II Echo, the IBM speech adapter, and even some Atari games. That's also the reason why we're using an Arduino alongside the Wemos board, as the library is incompatible with the Wemos board. To prevent the Arduino from constantly talking, the button we attached previously will trigger the output to the speaker whenever it's pushed. For those of you playing along at home, the button was salvaged from the same bus I salvaged the fan I built in a previous video. The Wemos board and the Arduino are communicating via serial communication, where the current subscriber count is sent to the Arduino to be synthesized into speech. The code for this is somewhat involved, so I won't really dive into it, but it hinges a lot on various libraries, which I will link in the description of this video. If you want to do this yourself, just use the excellent examples provided with the libraries. The strong point of the Wemos board is that it's entirely programmable through the Arduino IDE, which means that if you know Arduino code, it's a simple way to get your projects connected to the web, and quite cheaply as well, as they can be had for just a few dollars. Anyway, back to our regular scheduled programming. As the gauge only goes up to 1000, the current subscriber count is somewhat truncated. It only counts the last 1000 subscribers, so once it reaches a full 1000, it rolls over back to zero. To find out the actual subscriber count, you have to lift the receiver and push the button.
84,234.
The synthesized speech is delightfully robotic British, as is expected from 80s speech synthesis, but I think that only adds to the project as a whole. If you'd want to repurpose this to measure something else, it's simply a matter of reprogramming the Wemos board to connect it to the appropriate API, as the Arduino board really doesn't care as long as it gets its numbers. I wish I could have made the manometer gauge do something as well, but for now it's just going to have to be a decorative piece on top. It was simply too mechanically intricate inside, and frankly too pretty to ruin.
Subscribe to Switch and Lever.
As always, I hope you enjoyed the video. And you know the drill, if you're bored, why not click and watch another? If you're one of the subscribers already counted, I take my hat off to you. Otherwise, click that subscribe button and head on over to Instagram as well to check out what's new. Until next time!